बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। वी विल कंटिन्यू विद आवर टॉपिक इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड पोर्टफोलियो मैनेजमेंट MGT531। द रेफरेंस ऑफ द कोर्स इज एज वी डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर बाय द क्रिस्टीना 2010 दैट द बुक इज रिटन ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट एनालिसिस एंड पोर्टफोलियो मैनेजमेंट बाय द लिथुआनिया यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे लेक्चर इज लेक्चर नंबर 4। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस द समरी ऑफ द लास्ट लेक्चर। That is, in last lecture we discussed the types of financial investment vehicles. That is, what are the different types of financial investment vehicles that any individual investor can keep in his or her portfolio holdings. We have two basic types of investment vehicles. First are short term investment vehicles, then we have long term investment vehicles. Among the short term investment vehicles, in last lecture we discussed the certificates of deposits. That is, what are certificates of deposits and what are the characteristics and why any individual investor should undertake this type of investment or keep these in his or her portfolio holdings. Then we have treasury bills. As far as treasury bills are concerned, we discussed their characteristics in the last lecture. Also, we discussed the commercial papers in last lecture, besides we discussed the liquidity and the date of maturity or the time period of the maturity of all these certificates, bills and commercial papers that any individual investor can keep in his or her portfolio holdings. Then we discuss the banker's acceptance. That what is the banker's acceptance, and what is the reason to have the banker's acceptance by any individual investors. That is, we can say that why any individual investor needs to have banker's acceptance. We discuss that if any individual fails to pay back his loan in prior or in advance, he takes the banker's acceptance to repay his or her loan. Then we discuss the repurchase agreements, that what are these agreements and how they are helpful for the investor in order to keep them in the investor portfolio. Secondly, we discuss the long-term investment. That is another important type of financial investment vehicle. Among the long-term investment, we have different type of investment. For example, we have preferred stock, we have common stock, and we have speculators. We also discuss the hedges and speculators. That is, what are hedges and what are speculators? What is the nature of investment as far as speculation is concerned? What is the nature of investment as far as hedging is concerned? And how they are helpful for the individual investor in order to guide the individual investors to keep them or to be speculator or to be hedger in order to have maximum benefit of their investment in order to generate their wealth. Today's lecture comprises of financial markets. Today, that is, we will discuss the important form of the course, which is about the portfolio management and investment. And financial markets plays an important role and plays a basic and significant role in order to guide the individual investor, in order to guide the institutional investor to undertake their investment in a set of portfolio or the portfolio holdings. What are the characteristics of financial markets? What is the role of financial market in order to be helpful for the investors to make money or to undertake the investment for the further generation of wealth? If we are able to properly utilize all these channels, if we are able to properly utilize all these factors and the information from the market, we will be able to improve the level of wealth as an individual investor. We will be able to improve our level of wealth as an institutional investor, and on the whole, we can say we will be able to improve the standards of living of ourselves and as well as that of the people of the country, and as a whole, the economy of the country will grow. And as far as the financial markets are concerned, we will discuss the basic types, primary markets and secondary markets. And we will discuss the characteristics, how these markets are characterized and what is exchange. The first topic is for today's lecture is about the financial markets. What are financial markets? Financial markets are the important component of investment environment. In last lecture, we also discussed the environment, besides discussing investment vehicles, at what are different types of investment tools, what are different types of investment instruments and items that we can keep in our portfolio holdings, that we can purchase as a part of our portfolio holdings in order to extract maximum benefit, in order to extract maximum outcome of our decisions about portfolio holdings. We also discuss the environment of investment, that is what should be the important environment with the help of which are under which we are able to extract maximum benefit of our investment and with the minimum cost. And we yesterday lecture we also discussed the least cost combination, that as investors and as a person who is willing to fund his project to make the money, to generate the money, and as an investor to generate the money, the important is to have least cost combination. That is the objective of the investor as an individual investor or as institutional investor, is to have minimum cost of investment, or in other words, as far as the financial assets are concerned, or the investment in financial assets is concerned, as an investor we are likely to have minimum cost of purchase, minimum cost of buying of these assets with the maximum possible benefit. And we can say that if we can do this, if we are able to satisfy least cost combination of our choices, of our decision, we will be able to minimize the cost and we will be able to have efficient decision of our investment. That is, such type of decisions are known as efficient decisions, which gives us maximum benefit. Financial markets are the part of the investment environment. That is, we can say that if the financial markets, they elaborate the investment environment. What is the investment environment and how the market is working and functional? What type of environment market is providing to the investor? Whether they can be satisfied, are going to be satisfied with their investment, or they are going to be tensed with their investment. Definitely there is a huge or significant difference between the tension from or depression from the investment or not being relaxed. And on the other hand, if we are relaxed, what is the impact of being relaxed type of investment? If we are having the investment with the relaxation, so we can say we are enjoying our investment. Or we are able to get maximum benefit of our investment. On the other hand, if we are not able to enjoy our investment, that we can say we are not relaxed with our investment. It indicates the depressed sort of environment. That is why we can say why the environment of investment is important as far as investment is concerned. Whatever is the level of scale of the investment, the investment environment is too much important. We can say that financial markets, they elaborate the important type of important segment of important component of investment environment. Financial markets are designed basically to allow corporations, to allow governments to raise new funds. We can say that it is a forum. Financial markets provide the forum. It provides the stage for the investors to come and to play their role, and to make their investment, and to try to find out maximum possible positive benefit out of their role and out of their investments. So what is how these markets are designed? These markets are basically designed in order to allow corporations, in order to allow governments to raise new funds, so that they can raise new funds to make further investments. And second important reason for the that why the financial markets are designed is to allow investors to execute their buying and selling orders. We can say there are two important reasons in which there are two important lines on the basis of which these financial markets are designed. First one is that they help the corporations, these markets help the governments to raise the new funds for the further investment, to undertake further investment, to generate the funds, to generate the resources, to undertake new investment. And second is to allow investors to execute their buying and selling orders. That is, the investors, they can order, they can express their orders about the purchase of the financial assets, about the sale of the financial assets on this particular ground, on this particular forum or stage, which is known as the financial market. What are the channels of financial market? We have important channels of financial market. That is how the financial markets function, through which channel they are going to work, they are going to function. In the financial markets, funds are basically channeled. How the funds are channeled in the financial markets, funds and the resources, they are channeled from those who are in surplus. In other words, we can say that those who are having the funds, those who are availability of the funds, and they want to spend their funds, they want to allocate their funds somewhere to earn a further benefit, to earn further and to generate further wealth. Who are these people? These are basically those who are buyer of securities. These are those who are buyer of financial assets. So we can say that the people, the individuals who are in surplus of funds are those who are willing to purchase something. Those who are willing to purchase and buy the financial assets. And they are in intention to make the wealth from their current investment and from their current purchasings of securities. And these funds are channeled towards home. These are channeled towards home who are having shortage of the funds. Those who are having lack of the funds. And those who want the funds and resources in order to entertain their own objectives. Or unke apne objectives kya hai, jinke paas shortage hai funds ki, unke objectives kya honge. Definitely we are discussing about the investment, and the topic is investment and portfolio management. So those who are in the shortage of funds, the objective of them and the intention of them is also to finance further investment projects. So or further investment project karne ke liye they need the funds, therefore they sell their securities. So channel of the financial market funds are two. On one hand we have those who are in surplus of the funds, inko hum buyer kehte hain, buyer of the securities. Wo securities ko purchase karte hain, aur they pay the money for that. Aur wo money kisko dete hain? Definitely they are not throwing the money in the field. And the money is not extra so that they are throwing it out of their house, but they are giving the money, they are allocating their funds to some specific objective, to fulfill some important goal of their life and important goal of their own field of the investment. Or these funds are allocated to those who is the second part of this channel, or wo second part kaun bana rahe hain, those who are with the shortage of the funds, or ye wo log hain, those who are selling the securities, those who are providing the securities and selling to the buyers of the securities, in return they are getting the funds. And we can say they sell their security, existing securities, they are generating the funds for further investment or to finance their further projects of investment. Financial market can seen as a set of arrangements that allows trading among its participants. Therefore, we can say it is an organized system. Financial market basically represent an organized system of practitioners, of participants, or ye ek particular arrangement, a systematic or organized arrangement hai, jisme the participant they trade. Or the financial market allows the participants, allows its actors or its investors to take their role, to play their role in order to undertake the investment. That is, they play the role of the buying, and as a buyer they play the role as a buyer of the financial assets, and they on the other hand they play the role of sellers of investors. Further discussing the financial markets, financial market has three important economic functions. So we can say definitely financial markets are concerned with the economics of the investors, because they are providing the forum on which we are fulfilling our economic needs. We are satisfying our economic needs, we are satisfying our economic wants. And what is that economic want? Is to undertake the investment, to make the funds, to further generate the fund, and to be important part of the circular flow of investment, and to be important part of the circular flow of income of the economy, and circular flow of the income of the country. And according to important study by Frank J. Fabozzi, which was conducted in 1999, financial markets provide us with three different important economic functions. And what are these functions? The first important function is that financial market determines the prices of assets traded through the interaction between buyers and sellers. sellers. Definitely, whenever the price of any commodity, price of the financial asset or any entity or any item is evaluated and is settled down, we have two main agents. One are the buyers and second one are the sellers of these. And who are the buyers and who are the sellers? We have two important segments. On first end, we have buyers of these goods or services, buyers of the financial assets, buyers of the entities, and secondly, we have the sellers. And prices can be settled down. Prices can be decided only when we have these two important segments of the population. Jisme on one hand, we have buyers, those who are willing to buy the financial assets, those who are willing to buy the important entities of the economy, those who are willing to buy the goods and services. Or secondly, we have another segment, we have another component of the population. These are those who are sellers of the assets, those who are sellers of the commodities, those who are sellers of the services. Equilibrium is and we know that we have upward sloping supply function. Jab hum supply ki baat karte hain, for example, whenever we talk about the supply of the asset, financial assets, we have upward or positively sloped curve. इसमें वी हैव पॉजिटिवली स्लोप्ड कर्व, और जो इंडिकेट करता है कि प्राइस जब बढ़ती है तो सप्लाई बढ़ती है. प्राइस जिस किसी भी कमोडिटी की, फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स की प्राइस जब इंक्रीज करती है तो इसकी जो सप्लाई है वो भी इंक्रीज करती है. तो वी कैन से कि इंक्रीज इन द प्राइस ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स लीड्स टू इंक्रीज द सप्लाई ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स. इफ वी आर स्पेसिफिक towards discussing the supply and demand of these financial assets, so increase in the price of the financial assets leads to increase the supply of the financial assets. And secondly, we have another curve jisko hum kehte hain demand curve. I draw here, it is the demand curve, demand for the financial assets. For example, the curve shows negative relationship between the price of the financial assets and demand for the financial assets. Aur iska kya matlab hai? Iska matlab ye hai, jab bhi jo hai price zyada hoti hai to hamari demand jo hai wo kam ho jati hai, kyunki product is expensive now. Aur yahan pe kyunki first case mein kyunki price jo hai wo zyada hai, to sellers are willing to sell. It is the common phenomena of the financial market. It is the common phenomena of the goods market. It is the common phenomena of labor market. It is the common phenomena of money market and any other market, general market. We can say whenever the supply of the price of the any commodity increases, price of the financial asset increase, the investors or the suppliers of the assets, they will be willing to supply more and more assets so that they can earn maximum value out of their investments and out of their selling. Second is the negatively slow demand curve, which shows that there is negative relationship between the price of the financial assets and demand. Whenever the assets are expensive, the individual investors will be less willing to purchase those, or they will try to purchase those assets when they feel that the price is relatively at low level, so that they can save their funds. And when they can maintain a specific difference between the purchasing price of the assets and sale price of the assets. So difference jo hai purchase price ke darmiyan mein, aur jisko hum kehte hain selling price aur buying price ke darmiyan mein, they are able to maintain significant difference. Or when there is difference and the difference is positive, difference is greater than zero between the selling price and between the purchasing price of the assets, the individual investor will be willing to earn more and more of the financial wealth, and will be able to earn more and more out of the investment by maintaining this specific gap. So we can say financial market determines the prices of the assets, determine the equilibrium price of the assets. How this equilibrium price of the asset is determined? Definitely, it is determined through the difference between the price of the asset and the sale price of the asset and the purchase price of the asset. So, when equilibrium is maintained, we can get, if we draw these two curves in one diagram, we have upward sloping curve for the supply of the financial assets, we have downward sloping curve. For the demand for the financial assets, इस कर्व को हम पॉजिटिवली स्लोप्ड कहते हैं. जो हम ऊपर की तरफ जा रहा है, जो कर्व नीचे की तरफ आ रहा है, इसको हम नेगेटिवली स्लोप्ड कर्व कहते हैं. ये डिमांड को इंडिकेट करता है. हॉरिजॉन्टल एक्सिस के ऊपर वी हैव डिमांड फॉर द फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स, वी हैव सप्लाई ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स. एंड वर्टिकल एक्सिस के ऊपर वी हैव प्राइसेस, हमारे पास प्राइसेस ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स है. और जब दोनों कर्व इंटरसेक्ट करते हैं, व्हेन दे इंटरसेक्ट ईच अदर, व्हेन क्वांटिटी सप्लाइड ऑफ द एसेट्स इज इक्वल टू डिमांडेड, सप्लाई एस इंडिकेट द सप्लाइड और इज इक्वल टू क्वांटिटी डिमांडेड, तो वी हैव इक्विलिब्रियम प्राइस. ये हमें इंडिकेट करता है कि इक्विलिब्रियम प्राइस जो है वो डिटरमिन हुई है. और ये इक्विलिब्रियम प्राइस वो होती है जिसके ऊपर इंडिविजुअल इन्वेस्टर इज विलिंग टू बाय एज वेल एज सेल. दोज हु आर विलिंग टू सेल, दे आर विलिंग टू सेल देयर एसेट्स. एंड दोज हु आर विलिंग टू हु वांट टू परचेज द फाइनेंशियल एसेट, दे विल डिसाइड एंड दे विल एग्री टू बाय, दे विल एग्री टू परचेज एट दिस प्राइस जो कि इस क्रॉस के ऊपर आती है. और इस क्रॉस के ऊपर जो प्राइस आती है उसको हम पीई से इंडिकेट करते हैं. और ये पीई की जो प्राइस है इसको हम कहते हैं कि ये इक्विलिब्रियम लेवल ऑफ प्राइस है. दिस इज द प्राइस एट विच इंडिविजुअल बायर इन्वेस्टर बाइंग द एसेट्स इज विलिंग टू बाय, एंड इन्वेस्टर दो हु आर विलिंग टू सेल द एसेट इज विल लाइक टू सेल. और इस हॉरिजॉन्टल एक्सिस के ऊपर वी इंडिकेट दिस डेट डिमांड इज इक्वल टू क्वान्टिटी डिमांडेड इज इक्वल टू क्वान्टिटी ऑफ एसेट सप्लाई टू दी मार्किट. तो जितने लोग जो हैं वो मार्किट में दे वॉन्ट टू सेल देयर एसेट्स और दोज वॉन्ट टू बाय देयर एसेट्स, दे आर इक्वलाइज एंड स्टेबल सिचुएशन इज डिटर्मन इन द मार्केट. तो फाइनेंशियल मार्केट्स आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट वंस विच डिटर्मन द प्राइसेज ऑफ द एसेट थ्रू ट्रेड. और वट इज दिस, ऑल दिस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड हेयर थ्रू दिस पिक्चर एंड थ्रू द सप्लाई एंड डिमांड कर्व्स एंड थ्रू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द इक्विलिब्रियम प्राइस इज इंडिकेटिंग द ट्रेड trade with respect to financial assets between the supplier of the financial assets and between the buyer of the financial assets. And this is basically, this indicates the interaction between the supplier of the financial assets as well as buyer of the financial assets. Second important component of economic function of the financial market is that financial markets provide a liquidity of the financial assets. And as we discussed in the last lecture, that why the liquidity is important, what is the concept of the liquidity, we discussed in the last lecture that liquidity indicates the ease, it indicates the comfort, it indicates the facilitation with the help of which the financial asset can be converted into cash. Or in other words, we can say it is the ease with which any financial asset can be sold to the financial market. And immediately, that is whenever we want to sell any financial asset, we have the buyers available in the market. There are the individuals who are willing to buy that asset, and immediately we can convert the financial asset into the cash and into the in the monetary terms, and we can have the cash and we can have the units of money in return immediately. And why the liquidity of the financial assets is important? Why the liquidity of the financial assets is important? We know that this is important because when this tells us whenever we want to have the cash, we have cash. It basically, it makes sure the liquidity, the concept of liquidity makes sure that whenever we want to have cash, we can have. Whenever we want to have money in monetary units, we can have money in monetary units rather than in the financial assets. Or we can use our cash, we can use that money in order to fulfill our objectives. For example, if we want to spend our debt available cash or debt monetary items on any personal need in order to finance our household expenditures immediate, or certain household expenditure that may arise immediately or that may arise as a shock in the environment with reference to particular our own environment, which is our family, For example, there may be some accident, there may be some health issue, there may be some other household problems. We need the money, so liquidity is important in this respect. And also it is important when we are willing to and we have obligation to purchase some new financial assets, and we want to sell our existing financial assets immediately in respect of or in the objective of purchasing new financial assets. That is why we can say that liquidity is important in this respect, or this is the second important characteristics of financial market. We can say that financial market provides us the component, it provides us the stage, it provides us the forum on which financial assets can be converted into liquid money, it can be converted into the cash and monetary units of money, so that we can utilize, we can fulfill our need immediately on the spot. So what is the third important economic component of the financial market? That is, financial market reduces the cost of transaction by reducing explicit cost. और इसमें जो कॉस्ट ऑफ ट्रांजैक्शन होती है, इट इज आल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट कि हमें, फॉर एग्जांपल हम कहते हैं हमें लेन देन करने के लिए जो है वी नीड सम प्रॉपर प्लेस, हमें किसी चीज की प्रॉपर प्लेस की जरूरत है, वी नीड सम प्रॉपर ऑफिस, सम इंस्टीट्यूट, सम बाउंड्रीज ऑन विच एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ विच वी कैन मेक आर ट्रांजेक्शंस. For example, if we are the buyer of the assets, we have to make the payments. If we are seller of the assets, and if we are seller, we have to take the money from the buyer, and because we are the seller and supplier of the financial assets. So what is the important characteristic of the financial market is that it reduces the cost of transactions. Hame iske liye agar kyunki cost of transaction jo hai wo us waqt badhti hai jab hame it involves the time cost, it involves the monetary cost, or it involves the travelling cost. For example, अगर हमें बहुत दूर जाना पड़े, किसी एक शहर से दूसरे शहर जाना पड़े in order to undertake the transaction, हमें अपने जो हमने financial assets purchase किए हैं उनको उनकी payment करने के लिए हमें कहीं और किसी दूसरे शहर में जाना पड़े, और it will involve different cost, it will involve the monetary cost, monetary expenses of the individual investor, और इसके साथ ये time cost in terms of time जो है वो involve होगी, cost in terms of travelling involve होगी. ट्रेवलिंग जो है इट बेसिकली शोज द टायर्डनेस, कि वी बिकम टायर और वी डू नॉट फील कंफर्टेबल व्हेन वी हैव टू हैव द लॉन्ग ट्रेवल. डेट इज फाइनेंशियल मार्केट बेसिकली प्रोवाइड अस ए स्टेज विच रिड्यूसेस द कॉस्ट ऑफ ट्रांजैक्शन बाय रिड्यूसिंग द एक्सप्लिसिट कॉस्ट, और इट मेक अस कंफर्टेबल विद द परचेज एंड सेल ऑफ आर फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स. और एक्सप्लिसिट कॉस्ट जो है वो कौन सी है, सच एज मनी स्पेंट टू एडवर्टाइज, अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट कॉस्ट. कि हमें ट्रांजेक्शन करने से पहले अगर इफ वी वांट टू शो समवन दैट वी हैव समथिंग टू सेल और वी वांट टू बाय सम एसेट्स, वी हैव टू मेक द इंफॉर्मेशन अवेलेबल टू द अदर्स. द वन इम्पॉर्टेंट सोर्स इज एडवर्टीजमेंट, और थ्रू द एडवर्टीजमेंट और विद द हेल्प ऑफ द एडवर्टीजमेंट कंपनीज वी कैन परचेज एंड सेल फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स, एंड वी हैव टू डेफिनेटली मेक द पेमेंट्स फॉर दिस. To acquire this information, we have to spend the time, we have to spend the attention, we have to spend our emotions, we have to spend our brain, we have to and thinking, and we have to spend the money. So we can say all these are the different types of explicit cost that we have to allocate in order to take the information about the purchase and sale of our financial assets, and in order to make the final transactions when we have purchased the assets or we have sold the assets. Financial market could be classified on the basis of different characteristics. What are these characteristics which are likely to, which are going to classify the financial market? First is sequence of transactions for selling and buying securities. कि किस sequence में हम अपनी transactions बना रहे हैं? For the buying and selling of securities, in what sequence we are undertaking our transactions? Whether we are seller of the assets, we have or are the buyer of the assets, we have to go through and we have the interaction. If we are seller, we have the interaction with the buyer. If we are buyer, we have the interaction with the seller. So we have some interaction with the second party and we are involved in this transaction. So what is the sequence of the transaction is important in this respect. Second is terms of circulation of financial assets traded in the market. Yani ke jo financial assets humne market mein trade kiye unki circulation ki terms kya hai, kin terms ki base pe they are circulating in the economy. Third important the characteristics on the basis of which financial markets are characterized is economic nature of securities traded in the market. Jo market mein humne securities trade kiye unki economic nature kya, what is their economic nature. First is by the sequence of transactions for selling and buying securities we have two important markets which indicate the sequence of transaction for buying and selling, that is how the buying and selling can takes place and what is the, what can be this possible sequence systematic pattern of the buying and selling of these securities. First are primary market and then we have secondary market. All securities are first traded in the primary market and then in the secondary market. So this is the important and interesting aspect of the characteristics of and classification of the financial markets, that the securities they are traded, they go through during the trade, when they are being traded they go through both of these markets, they go through the primary market as well as they go through the secondary market. So these provide liquidity for these. Also sequence of transaction jo hai iski help se we can have the liquidity for these securities, provide the liquidities for these securities. Primary or secondary market jo hoti hain, these are helpful to provide the liquidity for these securities, ki jo securities humne purchase kiye hain with the help of these markets we can make them more liquid. Okay, they can be easily, these markets basically primary or secondary, they help us to undertake the purchase and sale of the securities and to make the purchase and sale and particularly the nature of the securities more liquid, that is they can be easily convertible into the cash, they can be easily convertible into the monetary units which can be directly used for to undertake the other transactions, for example household, daily household transactions to fulfill our basic daily life needs. Primary market, what is primary market? The first important and interesting concept or classification of the type of classification of the financial market is primary market. Primary market is where corporation and government entities can raise capital. That is, this is the forum, this is the stage with the help of which are on which the corporations and the government they can raise the capital. And why capital is needed? Definitely we need the capital to generate further wealth, we need the capital to undertake investment, we need the capital to finance our investment projects, or hum apne investment ko projects ko finance karte hain, we meet the expenditures of these projects with the help of feasibility report and we can have further positive outcome of these projects. That is, we can say that we are again going to extract maximum benefit or maximum efficient benefit of the out of these investment. Or secondly, with the help of primary market, where the first transaction with the new issued securities are performed. The important and interesting aspect of the primary market is that on one hand corporations and government they can work, they can function to raise the capital for further investment. Secondly, here the first transactions with the new issued securities can take place. That is, the primary market can provide us the forum, they provide us the stage, they provide us the place where we can make the first transaction when new securities are issued by the corporations, they are issued by the government. The third important point is that what are primary markets. If a company share is traded in primary market for the first time, this is referred to as an initial public offering. This is an important interesting concept which we can link in the primary market, because in the primary market the new issuing securities they come primary market and new issuing securities for that, because they can be traded in the primary market and the transaction for them the first transaction are traded in the primary market takes place in the primary market, so we can say that what are the initial important concept is initial public offering. What is initial public offering? Because the company's share is traded in the primary market for the first time and this concept is known as initial public offering, so we can say that second characteristics jisme humne kaha ki new issuing securities they are traded and the transactions, the first transaction takes place in the primary market, we can say second and third point they are closely related with each other, and you can say that third point, which is indicating the concept of initial public offering, is further elaborating the second concept. Then we have investment banks. Investment concept of investment banks. Investment banks play an important role in the primary market. We can say this is the first, this is the important example. Investment banks are important example of the primary market, or they play an important role in the primary market. In the function of primary market to complete in the function of primary market to take place. Usually they handle these investment banks, they handle issues in the primary market. जो इश्यूज प्राइमरी मार्केट में विद रिस्पेक्ट टू परचेज एंड सेल अराइज होते हैं दे कैन बी हैंडल्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ द इन्वेस्टमेंट मार्केट. डेफिनेटली व्हेन द फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स दे आर बॉट इन द प्राइमरी मार्केट, व्हेन फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स दे आर सोल्ड इन द प्राइमरी मार्केट, तो व्हाट हैपन, देर मे बी सम इश्यूज, देर मे सम फैक्टर्स विच अराइज इन द मार्केट, तो इन्वेस्टमेंट बैंक कैन कवर दो, कैन एडजस्ट विद दो इश्यूज and so that the function can or the transaction can take place smoothly in a balanced way, in a systematic way. Among other things, that these investment banks, they act as the underwriter of a new issue. वो एक किसी भी न्यू इशू के अंडरराइटर के तौर पे काम करते हैं एंड गारंटी द प्रोसीड्स टू द इशूअर. जो इश्यूअर होता है उसको उसको फॉर एग्जांपल अगर कोई नई मार्केट्स में नई सिक्योरिटीज आती हैं, द कॉन्सेप्ट मे बी लिंक्ड विद द न्यू सिक्योरिटीज इशूड इन द मार्केट फॉर इन्वेस्टमेंट बैंक्स. व्हेन न्यू सिक्योरिटीज कम अप इन द मार्केट दे हैंडल दीज मार्केट्स एंड दे एक्ट एज अंडरराइटर ऑफ दीज न्यू इशूज एंड दे ऑल्सो गारंटी द प्रोसीड्स टू द इशूअर. और वो जो इशूअर होता है, जो इशूइंग कंपनी होती है या बॉडी होती है, उसको वो गारंटी करते हैं कि प्रोसीड्स विल टेक प्लेस इन प्रॉपर वे और इन सिस्टमेटिक वे एंड सेटिस्फैक्ट्री वे. सेकेंड इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट इज द सेकेंडरी मार्केट. इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड इंटरेस्टिंग मार्केट टाइप इज सेकेंडरी मार्केट. Where previously issued, these are the markets where previously issued securities are traded among investors. Therefore, what is the difference between the primary and secondary? Primary or secondary may be different. Like new issues, जो है वो take place in the primary market, and the purchase and sale of the new issues takes place in the primary market, and also with its relevance, the transactions and the price. Prices transacted between two parties with the help of the primary market forum. However, in the secondary market, we have the trade of those issues which are already working in the market, which are already being purchased in the market, which are already being sold in the market. Generally, individual investors do not have access to secondary market. So another important and informative point is that individual investor, they do not have access to secondary market. Secondary market tak unki access nahi hoti, unki access zyada tar jo hai mostly jo hai most of the time, and they are able to access the primary market or they use security brokers. Ab secondary market mein function karne ke liye ya already जो इशूड सिक्योरिटीज होती हैं, इट इशूज फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स होते हैं जो ऑलरेडी मार्केट में परचेज एंड सेल हो रहे होते हैं, द एसेट्स एंड सिक्योरिटीज विच आर ऑलरेडी फंक्शनिंग एंड विच आर ऑलरेडी सर्कुलेटिंग इन द फाइनेंशियल मार्केट, उनकी फर्दर परचेज एंड सेल के लिए सेकेंडरी मार्केट में इन्वेस्टर टेक्स द हेल्प ऑफ द ब्रोकर. वो ब्रोकर की हेल्प से ये काम करते हैं और अपनी इन्वेस्टमेंट करते हैं. दे मेक सिक्योरिटी ब्रोकर्स टू दे यूज सिक्योरिटी ब्रोकर्स टू एक्ट एज इंटरमीडियरीज फॉर देम. वो उनके सिक्योरिटी ब्रोकर्स की हेल्प देते हैं, उनकी खिदमात देते हैं, उनकी सर्विसेज देते हैं. दे हायर द सिक्योरिटी ब्रोकर्स, देन दे आस्क देम टू गाइड देम इन एज इंटरमीडियरीज फॉर देम टू अंडरटेक देयर इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड टू परचेज द पर्टिकुलर आर इम्पोर्टेंट आइटम्स ऑफ देयर पोर्टफोलियो होल्डिंग. The broker delivers orders in the securities received from investors to a marketplace where these orders are executed. So we can say what is the role of these brokers? ये ब्रोकर क्या करते हैं? ब्रोकर जो होते हैं, जब उनको इन्वेस्टर की तरफ से कोई ऑर्डर मिलता है तो दे डिलीवर द ऑर्डर्स इन द मार्केट. और इन व्हाट टाइप ऑफ सिक्योरिटी द ऑर्डर इज बेसिकली नीडेड. तो दे डिलीवर, दे एक्सप्रेस द इंफॉर्मेशन, दे सर्कुलेट द इंफॉर्मेशन के जो है व्हाट टाइप ऑफ सिक्योरिटीज, व्हाट टाइप ऑफ सर्टिफिकेट्स, व्हाट टाइप ऑफ फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स आर नाउ बीइंग डिमांडेड बाय द इन्वेस्टर्स एंड दे डिलीवर द इंफॉर्मेशन टू द मार्केट एंड ऑर्डर द परचेज एंड एज ए रिजल्ट व्हाट हैपन्स द ऑर्डर्स आर एग्जीक्यूटेड एंड द बायर इन्वेस्टर विल बी एबल टू get the and will be able to buy the securities which are and the financial assets and certificates which are only already being circulated in the economy or in the repurchase and sale jo takes place in the economy. Finally, clearing and settlement process process ensure that both sides honor their commitment to these transactions. So as far as the secondary market is concerned, when we talk about the repurchase and resale of these the securities, repurchase and sale of the financial assets with the help of the broker in the financial markets, which indicate the particular type of the financial market, जिसको हम secondary market कहते हैं, तो उसमें both parties they abide by the law, they abide by their word, they abide by the commitment, and they make the final transaction and the clearance and settlement of the transaction and process takes place. What are the brokers? Brokers जो होते हैं, we know these are the intermediary bodies. They are the helping bodies. We can say they are the guide for the investors and who guide them to purchase what type of the assets in what quantity depending upon the situation prevailing in the market as far as the price of the buying price of the securities is concerned, as far as the sale price of the securities is concerned. They guide their investor, they guide their client, and definitely they get the charges for their services, but they are helpful for the investors in order to maintain, in order to have a proper and efficient portfolio with them. What are the types of broker? First type is discount broker. Who are discount brokers? Discount brokers are those who execute only trades in the secondary market. जो सिर्फ secondary market में अपना काम करते हैं, those who only work, only function in the secondary market, उनको हम discount broker कहते हैं. Then we have second type of the brokers. Second type of brokers are full service broker. और full service broker कौन है? Who provide a wide range of additional services to clients. और वाइड रेंज ऑफ एडिशनल सर्विसेज टू क्लाइंट का क्या मतलब है? दे प्रॉपरली गाइड द क्लाइंट इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द एग्जिस्टिंग मार्केट कंडीशन, इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द इंफॉर्मेशन, करंट एंड एडवांस एंड करंट एंड रीसेंट इंफॉर्मेशन प्रिवेलिंग इन द मार्केट, एज फार एज द प्राइस ऑफ द सिक्योरिटीज इज कंसर्न, एज फार एज द सेल प्राइस इज कंसर्न एंड बाइंग प्राइस इज कंसर्न, एज फार एज द वॉलेटिलिटी इज कंसर्न एंड एज फार एज द रूमर्स विच आर इमर्जिंग इन द market. And we know that there may be different other elements, there may be other different factors which are likely to influence the situation prevailing in the market. Jo market ki situation ko affect karte hain, wo aur bhi factors hote hain besides the economic factors. Hum economic factors ki baat karte hain to we have to talk about the internal political factors, we have to talk about the external political factor and the economic situation prevailing in the international market. Ye sari baat होती हैं जो कि मार्केट में वैल्यू ऑफ द एसेट्स को, वैल्यू ऑफ द सिक्योरिटीज को डिटरमिन करती हैं कि वेदर द प्राइस ऑफ द सिक्योरिटीज इज गोइंग टू बी स्टेबल फॉर सम टाइम और इट इज वोलेटाइल. तो फुल सर्विस ब्रोकर दे प्रोवाइड देयर फुल सर्विसेज टू देयर क्लाइंट्स. वो अपने क्लाइंट को पूरी सर्विस और कंप्लीट सर्विस प्रोवाइड करते हैं. इन द लाइट ऑफ दैट देयर क्लाइंट मे डिसाइड अबाउट द आइटम्स, अबाउट द इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स और टूल्स विच कैन बी परचेज एज पार्ट ऑफ हिज पोर्टफोलियो. और ये कौन से टूल्स और इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स होंगे दैट वी डिस्कस्ड ऑलरेडी दैट आर ऑब्जेक्टिव आर एज इन्वेस्टर इज टू मैक्सिमाइज आर बेनिफिट इज टू मिनिमाइज आर कॉस्ट और इस तरह के जो कॉन्सेप्ट होते हैं उनको हम कहते हैं कि ऑप्टिमाइजेशन द कॉन्सेप्ट लिंक विद दिस टाइप ऑफ डिसीजन इज ऑप्टिमाइजेशन ऑप्टिमाइजेशन का मतलब ये होता है मिनिमम कॉस्ट और मैक्सिमम बेनिफिट मैक्सिमम प्राइस मिनिमम कॉस्ट एंड मैक्सिमम प्राइस और व्हाट इज मेंट बाय मिनिमम कॉस्ट एंड मैक्सिमम प्राइस इसको हम लीस्ट कॉस्ट कॉम्बिनेशन कहते हैं ये वो लेवल होता है जिससे वी कैन हैव मैक्सिमम बेनिफिट वी कैन हैव एक्स्ट्रा एंड एफिशिएंट बेनिफिट आउट ऑफ आवर परचेज तो इन द लाइट ऑफ द इंफॉर्मेशन प्रोवाइडेड आर द गाइड ऑफ द गाइड In the light of the guide provided by the full service broker, the individual investor they can undertake efficient decision. वो अपने efficient decision जो होते हैं वो ले सकते हैं because the broker will provide them advice what type of assets to buy or what type of assets to sell and at what time in what quantity and what price should be offered as far as the buying is concerned and what price should be ordered as far as sale of the assets is concerned. थर्ड इम्पॉर्टेंट टाइप ऑफ ब्रोकर्स आर ऑनलाइन ब्रोकर्स इनको हम ऑनलाइन ब्रोकर कहते हैं ऑनलाइन ब्रोकर्स दिस इज डेफिनेटली फैसिलिटेटिंग द फर्दर एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट टाइप ऑफ ब्रोकर्स हु आर फैसिलिटेटिंग द इन्वेस्टर्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ सेविंग द कॉस्ट ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शंस ऑफ परचेज एंड सेल ऑफ द एसेट्स और हम कह सकते हैं कि इट ऑल्सो सेव द टाइम इट सेव द फटीक इट सेव द टायर और हम विद रिलैक्सेशन विद कम्फर्ट वी आर एबल टू अंडरटेक आर इन्वेस्टमेंट वी आर एबल टू मेक द परचेजेस इन आर पोर्टफोलियो और हु आर दीज ऑनलाइन ब्रोकर ये ऑनलाइन ब्रोकर जो है ये कौन है ऑनलाइन ब्रोकर इज ए ब्रोकरेज फॉर्म बेसिकली दैट अलाउ इन्वेस्टर्स टू एग्जीक्यूट ट्रेड्स इलेक्ट्रॉनिकली यूजिंग द इंटरनेट और वी हैव ए नंबर ऑफ एग्जाम्पल करंटली वर्किंग एंड दिस इज द डेफिनेटली इन आर कंट्री दिस इज द रिसेंट फिनोमेना के हाउ दिस ऑनलाइन ब्रोकर दे हेल्प the individual investor to undertake their investment whether the transaction and to undertake their transactions whether the transaction is with respect to buying whether is or it is with respect to sale now there in the market in the financial market we see a number of the offices or organizations or the companies they are working as to provide their services as the online broker तो जो है अब और इट इज फर्दर फैसिलिटेटिंग द इंडिविजुअल इन्वेस्टर्स के दे हैव मेड द ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल मोर देन वन मोस्ट प्रोबली दे हैव मेड ऑफिस and they are providing the guideline to the investors to undertake their transactions online or through internet and through telephonic talk they also help them और दे थ्रू द इंटरनेट मैसेजेस दे प्रोवाइड द सिचुएशन करंट सिचुएशन ऑफ द मार्केट करंट सिचुएशन ऑफ द मार्केट फाइनेंशियल मार्केट इज प्रोवाइडेड विद द हेल्प ऑफ ईमेल मैसेजेस विद द हेल्प ऑफ इंटरनेट मैसेजेस फॉर एग्जांपल व्हाट इज द स्टेबिलिटी हाउ मच इज द स्टेबिलिटी इन द मार्केट वेदर मार्केट इज स्टेबल और इट इज वोलेटाइल फ्लक्चुएशंस जो है शार्प फ्लक्चुएशंस मार्केट में हो रही हैं या मार्केट जो है वो स्टेबल है फॉर सम टाइम आर देर आर शार्प फ्लक्चुएशंस इन द मार्केट एज फार एज प्राइसेस ऑफ द सिक्योरिटीज इज कंसर्न एज फार एज प्राइसेस ऑफ द एसेट्स इज कंसर्न तो जब मार्केट में वोलेटिलिटी होती है एज वी डिस्कस्ड यस्टरडे इट इज द सिचुएशन बिकम मोर एंड मोर रिस्की और जब मार्केट में वोलेटिलिटी होती है वी सी दैट द ट्रेंड इज डाउनवर्ड और वी फाइंड ए डाउनवर्ड ट्रेंड और डाउनवर्ड ट्रेंड में हमें ये पता चलता है कि प्राइस जो है वो कम हो रही है एसेट्स की तो इट इज़ नॉट गुड टू सेल द एसेट्स एसेट्स को सेल करना जो है वो ठीक नहीं होता सिक्योरिटीज को सेल करना ठीक नहीं होता और द ऑनलाइन ब्रोकर्स दे प्रोवाइड इंफॉर्मेशन टू द इन्वेस्टर्स दैट दिस इज द टाइम टू मेक द परचेजेस This is the time to buy the assets, to buy the financial securities and assets. So for how much they may sometimes, depending upon the current situation, depending on the past behavior of the financial assets, they can assess the situation that how many days, or in other words, we can say what can be the possible period for this volatility. ये volatility कितने दिन जो है वो remain करती है, कितने दिन ये एग्जिस्ट करती है और विद द डाउनवर्ड ट्रेंड. और समटाइम्स वी सी दैट अपवर्ड वॉलेटिलिटी इन द पॉजिटिव वॉलेटिलिटी इन द मार्केट, जिसमें शार्पली देर इज शार्प इंक्रीज इन द प्राइसेस ऑफ द सिक्योरिटीज इन द प्राइसेस ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स. और उसमें जो है वी कैन से कि वो वॉलेटिलिटी जो है वो पॉजिटिव की तरफ जा रही है. तो दिस डेट विल बी द ब्रोकर्स, ब्रोकर्स में गाइड द इन्वेस्टर दैट दैट इज द बेस्ट टाइम एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट टाइम टू सेल द एसेट्स रादर देन टू परचेज, बिकॉज वेन द प्राइसेज आर एट टू द मैक्सिमम level and they are near the maximum, that will not be definitely good time to make the purchases, rather the to sell the purchases, क्योंकि it is quite possible जब किसी asset की price जो है वो peak के ऊपर पहुंच जाती है, it is near the peak और we make the purchases at this point for example, or afterwards it is quite possible कि prices start falling, then we may have incurred the loss in this, definitely it will desperate the investor. तो ब्रोकर जो है वो उसको गाइड करता है, फुल सर्विस ब्रोकर, ऑनलाइन ब्रोकर, दे डेफिनेटली हैव देयर डिफरेंट मेथड्स. कुछ जो होते हैं वो उन्होंने ऑफिस में लोगों को बुला के एज ए कंसल्टेंट जो है फेस टू फेस दे प्रोवाइड दे सर्विसेज एज ए गाइड, और जो ऑनलाइन ब्रोकर होते हैं वो ऑनलाइन इमीडिएटली दे डू देयर वर्क और देयर दे परफॉर्म देयर ड्यूटी. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट to be discussed as far as the situation of financial market or environment of financial market is concerned, because or the volatility hoti hai, we also discuss that economic situation of the country, that is internal economic situation, four important factors, the external international level economic situation influence this, internal economic situation influence this, internal political as well as external political factors influence the situation prevailing in the financial market, that it is likely to determine the current situation or the volatility in the as far as the prices of the assets is concerned. So therefore it is important as to be efficient manager of the portfolio holdings, we will have to have the complete information, we will have to open our brain, we will have to be completely aware about the current situation. तो current situation जो हमारे financial market की है उसकी full information होना और अपने खुले brain के साथ अपने पूरे complete शऊर के साथ awareness के साथ, it is important to be good investor, it is important to be efficient investor and manager, और जो है at the end will be able to maintain significant difference between the buying price of the securities and financial assets as well as the sale price of securities and financial assets, and we will be able to extract maximum benefit out of this. What are the types of secondary marketplaces? सेकेंडरी मार्केट प्लेसेस की क्या टाइप्स हैं? पहली टाइप, फर्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टाइप इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड सिक्योरिटी एक्सचेंज. पहली जो टाइप है उसको हम ऑर्गेनाइज्ड सिक्योरिटी एक्सचेंज कहते हैं, सेकेंड को हम कहते हैं ओवर द काउंटर मार्केट, और डेफिनेटली वी विल डिस्कस लेटर ऑन अबाउट द डिटेल ऑफ दीज, और थर्ड इज ऑल्टरनेटिव ट्रेडिंग सिस्टम, कि व्हाट इज ऑल्टरनेटिव, व्हाट कैन बी द ऑल्टरनेटिव ट्रेडिंग सिस्टम एज फार एज दिस इज कंसर्न. First of all, we have organized security exchange. Organized security exchange provides the facility for the members to trade securities, and only exchange members may trade there. So this is the important aspect, this is the important characteristics of the organized security exchange, that they provide the services, they facilitate its members to trade the securities. Or it is an organized system, as it is apparent from the name of this exchange, it is apparent from the name of this security exchange, we know that it is an organized and systematic pattern, a systematic and organized exchange which provides services to its clients, to its members, to trade their securities, to buy the securities, to sell the securities. And or only the but the important restriction is that only the members of the exchange can trade there, those who have taken the membership, those who have who are the registered member, and they can trade, they can make the purchases of the securities, they can make the sale of the securities with the help of these organized security exchange. We can say that secondary market provides this important service. This type of secondary market, which is known as organized exchange, requires its members to be registered in advance, ताकि वो एडवांस में रजिस्टर्ड हो और उनकी इंफॉर्मेशन जो है वो इस एक्सचेंज के पास हो, और सो डेट दे कैन प्रोवाइड दम द स्टेज, दे कैन प्रोवाइड दम द फॉरम, डेफिनेटली इन द फाइनेंशियल मार्केट दे कैन प्रोवाइड दम द कंप्लीट गाइडेंस एंड कंप्लीट इंफॉर्मेशन एज फार एज द परचेज एंड सेल ऑफ द सिक्योरिटीज इज कंसर्न, और दे गाइड दम इन ए प्रॉपर वे to be investor who is likely to have maximum benefit, who is likely to generate the wealth in the near future. Who are exchange members? अब जैसे हमने कहा कि एक्सचेंज मेंबर्स जो हैं, दे आर दिस टाइप ऑफ द एक्सचेंज रिक्वायर्स इट्स मेंबर टू बी रजिस्टर्ड, कि वो रजिस्टर्ड हों और वो इन एडवांस इसके मेंबर्स हों. तो कौन हैं जो कि इसके एक्सचेंज मेंबर बन सकते हैं? Who are exchange members? The members include brokerage firms. जो मेंबर्स होते हैं उसमें, ये मेंबर्स वो हैं ब्रोकरेज फर्म्स हैं, और विच ऑफर, और ये ब्रोकरेज फर्म्स कौन हैं? दे ऑफर देयर सर्विसेज टू इंडिविजुअल इन्वेस्टर्स. ये वो दीज ब्रोकरेज फर्म्स, दीज आर द मेंबर्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एक्सचेंज इन द सेकेंडरी मार्केट. तो वी कैन से दैट दिस इज सिंपल दिस चैनल ऑन वन हैंड, और दिस इज नॉट सो सिंपल ऑन द अदर हैंड. That we can say that organized exchange is the part of the secondary market, or we know that secondary market is the market where resale of the assets and repurchase of the assets take place. In other words, we can say that the assets are the securities which are being traded in the secondary market. They are not the ones which are newly issued, but they are those which are already issued, which are previously issued. और ये सेकेंडरी मार्केट में इम्पॉर्टेंट जो टाइप है वो ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एक्सचेंज है. व्हाट आर दी सेकेंडरी मार्केट, किसको हम सेकेंडरी मार्केट कहेंगे? तो टाइप ऑफ सेकेंडरी मार्केट में वी हैव ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एक्सचेंज. और ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एक्सचेंज में कौन है? इंडिविजुअल इन्वेस्टर की हमने बात जो है वो वी आसे के दीज आर दी ब्रोकरेज फर्म्स, not the, so we can say that directly investors cannot, in other words, we can say that direct investors cannot directly access the secondary market. Wo secondary market mein directly jaake apni jo hai transaction nahi kar sakte as far as purchase and sale of the securities and assets is concerned. Rather, they have to take the services of the brokerage firms. तो सेकेंड करेक्टरिस्टिक वी कैन से हु आर द मेंबर्स ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एक्सचेंज, वो ब्रोकरेज फर्म्स होती हैं. और ये ब्रोकरेज फर्म्स कौन होती हैं? ये वो होती हैं विच ऑफर सर्विसेज टू द इंडिविजुअल इन्वेस्टर्स. थे इंडिविजुअल इन्वेस्टर्स को अपनी सर्विसेज प्रोवाइड करती हैं. इंडिविजुअल जो है इन्वेस्टर्स, दे हायर देयर सर्विसेज एंड दे टेक दे टेक कंप्लीट इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द परचेज एंड सेल ऑफ द मार्केट एसेट्स, एंड दे कैन in return definitely they pay the charges, they pay the fee. And or ye jo to on the whole we can say brokerage firms, they charge the commissions for executing trades on their behalf. To jo trade hoti hai, the trade which is executed with and the asset which are being traded for them, these brokerage firms they take the service charges, or definitely in exchange for these charges they are very helpful. They are capable to maximize the benefit of the individual investor, and in the efficient way, or what is the efficient way, we have already discussed. In the efficient way, they will definitely help the individual investor to maximize their benefit with the least cost, and so that they can be able to generate the wealth in the near future. Second, other exchange members. पहले हैं ब्रोकरेज फर्म, सेकंड अदर एक्सचेंज मेंबर्स जिनको हम डीलर्स कहते हैं. अदर एक्सचेंज मेंबर्स आर द डीलर्स, दे बाय एंड सेल फॉर देयर ओन अकाउंट, फंक्शन एज ए डीलर्स और मार्केट मेकर. अब डीलर्स कौन होते हैं? डीलर्स वो होते हैं कि जो अपने लिए भी परचेज करते हैं. दे हैव देयर ओन अकाउंट इन द फाइनेंशियल मार्केट एंड दे मेक द परचेजेस फॉर देयर अकाउंट एंड दे मेक द ट्रांजेक्शन एज फॉर द सेल ऑल्सो That is when they make the purchase, they also sell the financial assets. They have their own accounts on one hand, or secondly, they also work for the others. वो दूसरों के लिए भी काम करते हैं और investors की भी help करते हैं, and they work as a guide for the other investors to guide them and to provide them the information as far as the purchase of the assets and sale of the assets is concerned, or they set the prices at which they are willing to buy and sell their own account. So they negotiate to purchase as far as the buying price is concerned and selling price is concerned. This is the today's important lecture, in which we discussed a different important aspects of the financial market. We discussed that we have important sequence of the transactions as a characteristics of the financial market, and we discussed the functions of the financial market. We discussed that as a sequence we have the primary markets, we have secondary markets, and we discussed in detail the important characteristics of the primary market. What are primary markets and what are their characteristics and how they are helpful for the individual investor. Or one important example was the investment bank, jisme humne kaha ki investment bank they help the investors to undertake their transactions and to make their transactions. They help them as a guide also. Or the primary market, the newcomers are new investors, are new securities. They feel comfortable and invest. Or जो primary market है, ये एक important forum है जिसकी help से new investors जो हैं वो investment करते हैं. और new जो securities होती हैं, they can be issued easily with comfort by the issuing company or issuing authority. Second market में हमने discuss किया कि secondary market में individual investors, they cannot directly function with the secondary market, but they have to work through the third body, एक तीसरी body के through they have to function, they have to make their investment. और वो body कौन सी होती है? जो वो brokers होते हैं, जिनको हमने intermediaries कहते हैं. Then we discussed the types of the brokers, के जो brokers हैं उनकी क्या types होती हैं. We discussed के they are discount workers, they are जो के discount में that is the in secondary market the only trades are executed with discount workers. Secondly, full time full service workers the jo unko proper guideline aur information ke aur proper consultant ke taur pe kaam karte hain. Fir humne kaha we have online workers, aur online workers jo hote hain wo kya karte hain ki wo they help the investors online, or minimum cost of traveling is that is the with this is important source of taking the guide for the investment with the online broker. That is the minimum cost is concerned, explicit cost is concerned. Then we started discussing the types of secondary market, or in the secondary market we discussed the first type, which is organized security exchange, or we discussed that this is a sort of the exchange. This may we have an organized setup, or this organized setup is providing the facility, is providing the service for its members to trade the securities, but only this type of exchange help its own members, registered members, or unko ye help karti hai to undertake their investment. And then we discussed that who are these members, who are the members of this exchange. Or isme we discussed that brokerage firms, they are the members of the of this exchange. Or these brokerage firms, they definitely provide their services to the investors, and they provide them the information about the purchase and sale of the assets, or they charge the commission, they charge the service charges definitely on the assets, on the securities being traded. Or then we have discussed that we have another type of the finance, another type of exchange in com kehte hain exchange, other exchange members, those who are dealers jo hote hain, inke do tarah ke function hote hain. They have their own accounts in the financial market or in the secondary market, or they make and purchase and sell for their own self, or they also work for the others. They provide their services to others to help them to guide the individual investors to make the purchases and to make the sale of their assets. So that is it. Inshallah, I hope that you will be able to understand all these concepts with the help of this lecture during your self-study. And this is the end of today's lecture. Inshallah, we will meet in next lecture with the continuation of these different types of secondary market. Allah Hafiz.